Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. This video will give you a quick overview of the main parts of Dashpivot. Here we are on the Dashpivot website. The first thing to understand is how to navigate through the system. So in the top left of the screen, you'll see this button here. If you click on this to open it up, you can see your company name and then all of the projects and teams that have been configured within your account. There are a couple of different ways to set this up. Some companies will set up a project folder with multiple team folders within that project. Others will set up a project folder for their client and then have different client sites sort of listed below. But if you're looking for something really simple to start with, you could just set up a general project and just have a general team within that just to get you started. Now, at the moment, we're looking at the project and you'll see that there's a section called lists. Lists function as databases, which can be referenced from within your form templates. So if you were filling out a form and needed a drop-down list for different personnel or pieces of equipment or contractors, you would set up a list in here and then link that later on to your form templates. Now, the list section can also help you to track information about the items in that list, such as someone's date of birth or their address, and you can actually set up automated notifications to let you know when a license or a service date is due for renewal. You can also upload copies of those documents into the list section as well. So it's quite handy to track and manage all of this information in this register style format. When it comes to the team folders, there's a few other sections. And this is typically where all of the data capture occurs. You've got your template section. This is where you can set up smart digital templates to replace Word docs, Excel spreadsheets, PDF docs, anything that was done on paper in times gone by. So you'll see we've got a number of templates in here. They're all organized into these different business functions. If we click on this one here, this site diary, we can see all of the underlying records that have been filled out so far using this template for the site diary. Everything's organized by date. If we open up the most recent one, we can actually see all the information that was filled out. So we've got the date, the location, the weather, the photos, and everything that you see here, some information in tables and so on. All of this information is customizable. So when you set up your Dashpivot account, you've got full control over what fields are shown, in what order, you can make some of them required. There's a lot of options that you have at your disposal. These templates can also be set up in one of two ways. What we're looking at here is a timeline template, which stores everything day by day. But we also have a workflow option, which looks slightly different. It lays out all of the forms into different columns, like we see here. And the idea is that you're moving the forms from the left side of the page to the right side of the page. It ensures that the process that you design is followed to a T. You've got report creation, report review, and then closed. And it relies on signing off those forms in order to progress it through. You can fill out these forms on your phone and on the website. Later on, you've also got a register option, which can help to dig into your data a little bit further once you're back at the office. We also have an analytics section in Dashpivot. The analytics section is used to visualize the information that's captured inside of your form templates. Here you can set up a series of dashboards, and each dashboard can contain multiple charts. So if we click on a particular dashboard, we can see we've got two charts. These charts can be used to track all sorts of things, production quantities, labor hours, costs, safety and quality KPIs, among other things. And each chart has a wide range of options and settings and filters which can be applied to drill into your data when you've got large data sets spanning many months or years inside the system. You've also got a photo section. Here you can see all of the photos and videos that have been uploaded by the team so far. They're all stored in date order, so we've got the most recent ones up the top, and as we scroll down, we're going back in time. You can upload the photos via the website or by using the Dashpivot app. There's a dedicated photo section in the app where you can take photos, and you can also review any of the photos that have been uploaded Each of the photos has additional information attached to it, like who took the photo, the photo itself, any tags that have been applied to it, any descriptions or comments, and then we've also got the GPS location stamped into the photo down the bottom as well. And there's a couple other options. You can stamp specific information onto the photo. You might want to have the GPS coordinates and the date and time that the photo was taken. You can stamp that into the photo itself. Last but not least, we've also got a home section. The home section tells us who has access to this team folder. We can see some different colors here for the different people's names. If you want to invite someone new, we can just type in their email and click the invite button. That will send them an email to get started with their Dashpivot account. And in the center of the screen, we just see an activity feed. So if anyone uploads a photo, fills out a form, creates a new chart, all of that information shows up in this activity feed with the most recent information up the top and the older information down the bottom. So that concludes this video. Please feel free to check out our other help articles and videos that we have available. If you get stuck or have a specific question, you can always reach our team via the live chat on the website as well. I hope that this video has been useful as an overview for Dashpivot, and thanks for watching.